Hi everyone, this is Vignesh from Easy Way to Learn Medicine. So today we are going to see the important keywords which are repeatedly asking in a Crokvon examination. So which are also called as Stepvon examination in Ukraine. So today we are going to see the helminth or parasitic worm. So I have seen the 5 years best question papers and 15 years question papers which are repeatedly asked the question. So I am concluded with 11 questions which are repeatedly. So this is the main pattern of questions. So they are asking these questions are in a repeated manner. So the questions is changed, but the answer is remains same. So this video, which will be useful for those who are appearing for Crokvon examination. So this video also helpful for those who are preparing for USML examination or a PLAB examination or any examination, maybe license examination or medical university examinations. So I have combined the medical biology and microbiology together in this video. So I'm not going to explain everything, but I'm going to explain in a examination manner. So you already did medical biology and microbiology, so I'm going to tell you in an examination type of manner. So we are going to see the helminth or parasitic worm. So the first helminth, which is called as opisthokiasis or liver fluke. So the opisthokiasis, which is a disease name like amoebiasis. So which helminth, which fluke? So the fluke name is called as opisthokiasis felinius. Opisthokiasis felinius. So most of the time they didn't give the opisthokiasis felinius. They most of the time they mentioned like opisthokiasis or liver fluke. So which is a foodborne infection? The snail, the first intermediate host is a snail. The fish, the freshwater fish, is the snail. So after that, the man is the fish. So those who are eating raw fish or unproper cooked fish, which is a freshwater fish, so those people will get opisthokiasis, which is a foodborne infection. In some of the questions, they ask the size of the egg, which is a smallest egg which compared to all among the helminth egg. So the egg which look like dark oval shaped operculum on one of the poles. Operculum on one of the poles. So the clinical feature. So there is a infection. So there will be a eosinophilia. Some of the patient, they don't have the symptoms. So there is an infection, so there is a eosinophilia, and there is a diarrhea, and there is a epigastric pain and pain in the upper right quadrant, and there is a loss of appetite, that is anorexia, and there is a fatigue, and they look like jaundice, fever. So it's look like a liver pathology symptoms. So it's like a cholecystitis, cholelithiasis, cholangitis. So why? Because this liver fluke lives in bile duct or a gallbladder or in a liver. So these symptoms are called as liver pain. So these symptoms are called as liver pain. So liver pain is a clue. Some people are asymptomatic. Also they given like chronic, in a chronic case there is edema, ascites, cholangitis, jaundice and gallbladder pathology. In some questions they gave like the egg is dark oval shaped operculum on one of the poles. Oval shape operculum on one of the poles. So you are eating fresh water fish, eating raw fish or uncooked fish. So for the patient of the people, those who ate raw fish or unproperly cooked fish, freshwater fish. So what the patient will have? Opisthochiasis, liver fluke, foodborne infections. So the fluke which live in the bile ducts, gallbladder, liver. So there will be a liver plane. Opisthochiasis, liver fluke, egg is dark oval shaped operculum on one of the poles. It look like liver pathology. So it make difficult to the bile duct and the gallbladder. So bile cannot come out. So there will be a cholelithiasis. There will be a inflammation in the gallbladder. So it look like liver pain. And the next one, which is very very important, because in the life everyone has seen this pinworm infection or enterobiasis. Pinworm infection or enterobiasis vermicularis. The worm name is called enterobius vermicularis, white worm. So everyone in a childhood has infected with this pinworm infection or white worm infection, because we play in the sand, we drink water outside, so we play. So this pinworm are very similar infection in a childhood. So how the clinical features will look like? The child will always itch in an anal or perianal area, always itching, and then there will be a sleeping difficulty. So the main clue is the children is always itching in a perianal area. Something is in my underpants, something is in my underwear, always itching in the anal area. So also you can see the white worm in a underwear, itching in the anal area, sleeping difficulty, or sometimes the parents can see the worms in a underwear. So the main clue. And then the eggs are look like asymmetric oval eggs, and which is called as filiform helminth, 0.5 to 1.5 centimeter long, pointed twisted ends, which look like this. So asymmetric oval eggs, filiform helminth, 0.5 1 centimeter long, pointed twisted ends. So this also they gave in the question. So how you can diagnose? Scraping from the perianal folds. So pinworm or white worm, enterobiasis caused by enterobius vermicularis, itching in a perianal area or anal area, directly conclude with enterobiasis, enterobius vermicularis, itching white worm. So also they can give like parents saw some whitish worm which look like alive in a underwear. So white worm or pinworm, enterobiasis, itching. So how you can diagnose? Scraping from perianal folds. So the next one, echinococcus granulosis or hyat worm or dog tape worm. This is name called as echinococcosis caused by echinococcus granulosis, also called as hyat worm or a dog tape worm. So please read the names and memorize the names, because sometimes they can give the names, or sometimes they can give the clinical picture, and you have to conclude with the names. So why echinococcosis, also called as dog tapeworm? Because it is transmitted by the dog. So by the dog feces, it contaminated with any materials. So that materials goes to the human, so humans also contaminated. So how the clinical features will look like? Right subcostal area pain. Nausea and vomiting. It directly affects the lungs. These granulosas, these worm lives in the lungs. These worms lives in the lungs. It and in and it affects lungs. So there will be a subcostal area pain, nausea, and vomiting. So these helminths look like a the helminth larvae, which is a spheric helminth larvae. So which, how it's look like spherical shape. So echinococcus granulosis transmitted by dog. Or in some of the cushion pattern, they gave like shepherd who has sheep. For the sheep maintenance, he has a dog. And the shepherd is came to a doctor and he has a right subcostal area pain, nausea, vomiting. So he has a dog. So from the dog, he can contaminate it. So we can conclude it with echinococcosis. So in a rhinoscopy, you can see tumor-like formation. So the worm will covered by a inflammatory cells, so there will be a tumor like formation. Don't forget echinococcosis transmitted by dog. So rabies dog. Don't forget echinococcosis dog transmitted by dog. The fourth one, Diplobothriasis tape or a tapeworm. The helminth name is Diplobothrium latum. Diplobothriasis, Diplobothrium latum. Who will get this Diplobothriasis? Those who are eating raw fish, not a freshwater fish, salty fish. Those who are eating raw salty fish or uncooked salty fish, for example, caviar. So those who are eating caviars, they are suspected to have a Diplobothriasis. We also see that those who are eating raw fish or uncooked raw fish, freshwater fish, those who will get opisthokiasis, liver fluke. In this situation, Diplobothriasis, those who are eating salt fish, eating salt fish in a raw manner, in an uncooked manner. So for example, caviar. So in the diagram, the A, which is scolex, and the B, which is a mature segment, and a C, which is a gravid segment. The number 2 and the number 4, which is a uterus. So when you see the uterus, which is look like rosette shaped uterus. When you see the uterus, it is look like in a cushion pattern they gave like this. There is a rosette shaped uterus. So concluded with Diplobothriasis, rosette shaped uterus. So how the clinical features look like? If the patient, those who are repeatedly eating raw fish, raw salty fish or uncooked salty fish, caviar. There is a hunger pain, dyspepsia, colic, diarrhea, pernicious anemia, because there is a malabsorption. So how you can diagnose this? Egg in a feces. So if it is a rosette shaped uterus, no doubt it is a tapeworm Diplobothriasis, or they can give like that. The patient are repeatedly eating raw uncooked salty fish, so Diplobothriasis. And the fifth one, filarial worm or filariasis. So in a filarial nematode or filarial helminth, we have under the filarial nematode we have one more helminth, which is called as lova. This filarial worm, it can cause an eye infection. Under the filarial worm, the helminth name called lova, it can cause filarial elephantiasis or lymphatic filariasis. So filarial worm, eye infection, and elephantiasis. So in eye infection, the patient have eye ache, eyelid edema, lacrimation, visual impairment. Also if it is lova, there will be a lymphatic filariasis or elephantiasis. So filarial worm, you have to conclude it with two diseases. One is eye infection, one is elephantiasis. So how the helminth is look like? 30 to 50 millimeter long with the elongated filiform body. Filarial worm, filiform body, which is elongated. It can cause two problems, which is eye infection and elephantiasis or lymphatic filariasis. Filiform body, filarial worm. So don't forget. And then Ascaris lumbricoides. This question also which have similar questions which are related to the Ascaris lumbricoides. So first we'll see the image, the A which is adult Ascaris, the A which is adult lumbric, adult Ascaris, Ascaris lumbricoides, and the B which is the internal organ of the female, and then the X of the Ascaris. Why? Because this image. So the Ascaris egg which is look like a oval shaped X. So see the image which is look like oval shape. Also the helminth which will look like spindle shape, which are around 20 centimeters. Spindle shape, 20 centimeter oval X. So Ascaris lumbricoides or large round worm, those who are eating raw vegetables, contaminated raw vegetables, not washing properly. So contaminated raw vegetables. So this Ascaris lumbricoides lives in a small intestine. We have a specific mechanism of pathway of the Ascaris, which is heart lung migration from heart to the lung and then small intestine. So when it goes to the lung, it causes pneumonia. So in a question pattern, most of the time it always associated with pneumonia. The patient has pneumonia, the patient has fever, the patient has cough, the patient has exportation of a sputum with blood, there is eosinophilia, and there is stomachache, vomiting, indigestion, weakness, diarrhea. So most of the time associated with pneumonia. So in a pneumonia, they can give like that. In a pneumonia patient, they found out some oval shaped helminth egg covered with thick tuberculate envelope in a sputum examination. They can give the like that. So most of the time is associated with pneumonia. So in a clinical features, general symptoms like fever, stomachache, indigestion, weakness, diarrhea and cough, always there is a pneumonia. In a feces examination, they can reveal the egg. The egg which is oval shaped helminth egg covered with thick tuberculate envelope. In a microscope examination, they reveal yellow brown knobby coated eggs of helminth with thick wall in feces. So yellow brown knobby coated eggs of helminth with thick wall in feces. In vomit, they found out spindle shaped helminth with 20 centimeters. In a blood examination, there will be a eosinophilia. Don't forget, if there is also always, if there is associated with pneumonia, Ascaris lumbricoides. So don't forget oval shaped tuberculate envelope and then yellow knobby coated eggs of helminth with the thick wall in feces and a spindle shaped helminth. The seventh one, which is trichinella or trichina or trichinosis. The main source, smoked pork or meat of wild animals. Those who are eating barbecue pork, smoked pork and the meat of wild animals, those people can get trichinella, trichinosis or trichina. The disease name is called trichinosis and the infection caused by the helminth which is trichina or trichinella. So the, how the clinical features will look like, there is a fever and there is a headache and swell in face and eyelids, and there is a muscle pain, myalgia, and there is gastrointestinal disturbance. ஸோ தீஸ் ஆர் த கிளினிக்கல் ஃபீச்சர்ஸ். அந்த மெயின் சோர்ஸ் ஸ்மோக்டு போர்க் ஆர் மீட் ஆஃப் வைல்டு அனிமல்ஸ். ட்ரிக்கினல்லா ஸ்பைராலிஸ். ஸோ திஸ் ட்ரிக்கினல்லா ஸ்பைராலிஸ் ஸோ வென் யூ சீன் சம் கொஷின்ஸ் தே கிவன் லைக் மசில் பயாப்சிஸ் ஆஸ் லார்வே அண்ட் பெயின் இன் சீவிங் மசில்ஸ். ஸோ டோன்ட் ஃபர்கட் மசில் பயாப்சி ஆஸ் அ லார்வே பெயின் இன் சீவிங் மசில்ஸ். ஸோ தேர் வில் பி அ ட்ரிக்கினல்லா ஸ்பைராலிஸ் அண்ட் ஆல்சோ ட்ரிக்யூரிஸ் ட்ரிக்யூரா ஆர் ட்ரைக்கோசெஃபாலுஸ் ட்ரிக்யூரிஸ் ஆர் விப்வாம் ஒயிட் ஹெல்மிந்த் ஃபவுண்டட் இன் அப்பண்டிக்ஸ் 40 சென்டிமீட்டர் லாங் வித் தின் ஃபில்லிஃபார்ம் எண்ட். ஸோ விப்வாம் ஆர் ட்ரைக்கோசெஃபாலுஸ் ட்ரிக்யூரிஸ் ஆர் ட்ரிக்யூரிஸ் ட்ரிக்யூரா ஆல்வேஸ் அசோசியேட்டட் வித் அப்பண்டிக்ஸ் த ஹெல்மிந்த் ஃபவுண்டட் ஒன்லி இன் த அப்பண்டிக்ஸ். டோன்ட் ஃபர்கட் வென் த கொஷின் பேட்டர்ன் தி கிவன் லைக் ஹெல்மிந்த் ஃபவுண்டட் இஸ் அப்பண்டிக்ஸ் ட்ரிக்கினல் ட்ரிக்கினலா ஆர் ட்ரி விப்வாம் ட்ரி ட்ரக்கியோசெஃபலஸ் ட்ரிக்யூரிஸ் ஸோ மசில் பயாப்சி ஆஸ் எ லார்வே பெயின் டூரிங் சீவிங் ட்ரிக்கினலா ஸ்பைராலிஸ் ஸ்மோக்டு போர்க் ட்ரிக்கினலா ஆர் ட்ரிக்கினோசிஸ். ஸோ டோன்ட் ஃபர்கட் த்ரீ ட்ரிக்கினலா ட்ரிக்கினலா ஸ்பைராலிஸ் விப்வாம். இந்த 8th one டீனியா சோலியும் ஆர் அ போர்க் வாம் த மெயின் சோர்ஸ் ஆல்சோ இஸ் அ போர்க். இந்த கிளினிக்கல் ஃபீச்சர்ஸ் தேர் இஸ் எ கேஸ்ட்ரோ இன்டெஸ்டினல் ப்ராப்ளம் அண்ட் அ வீக்னஸ். ஸோ த லார்வா விச் ஹேஸ் 7 to 12 லேட்ரல் பிரான்ச்சஸ் அண்ட் ஹெட் ஹேஸ் எ ஹூக் வித் 4 suckers. ஹிட் ஆஸ் எ ஹூக் வித் 4 suckers. 7 to 12 லேட்ரல் பிரான்ச்சஸ். டோன்ட் ஃபர்கட் 7 to 12 லேட்ரல் பிரான்ச்சஸ் விச் இஸ் டீனியா சோலியம். ஸோ திஸ் டீனியா சோலியம் இட் லீட்ஸ் டு சிஸ்டி சிர்கோசிஸ் விச் இஸ் எ வார்ம் லார்வல் ஸ்டேஜ் விச் லேட்டர் ஆன் affect the brain which is called as cysticercosis. So don't forget if there is a cysticercosis and 7 to 12 lateral branches tinea solium. Don't forget 7 to 12 lateral branches tinea solium cysticercosis. And the next one which is tinea saginata. So which is caused by eating pork, sorry, eating beef. So this one is not correct. Tinea solium is a pork. Tinea saginata is caused by those who are eating unproper cooked beef. So is also called as beef worm. The clinical features look like general weakness, indigestion. And uterus, the helminth uterus, which has 15 to 30 lateral branches. So don't forget 7 to 12 is tinea solium, 15 to 30 which is tinea saginata, which also cause cysticercosis, but the name differs. Cysticercosis bovis, which is tinea saginata, cysticercosis cellulose, which is tinea solium. So tinea saginata, beef. Tinea solium, which is pork. And the 10th one, schistosomiasis, or a flatworm, or a blood flukes. Schistosomiasis, or a flatworm, or a blood flukes. So you can get this schistosomiasis. The people who are swimming in a river, those people often gets schistosomiasis. Because the water is contaminated, if the water is not clean, so you will get schistosomiasis. So the main source, snail and also swimming in a river. Pain during urination, urine analysis revealed egg, which is called as urogenital schistosomiasis. So pain during urination, urine analysis revealed egg. So a urinary bladder or in a kidney, there is a presence of egg or a worm. So it's called as urogenital schistosomiasis, or the pain during urination, urine analysis revealed large terminally spited eggs, which is called as schistostoma hematobium. Urogenital hematobium. So don't forget schistosomiasis, swimming in river, pain during urination, urogenital schistosomiasis, pain during urination and urine analysis revealed large terminally spitted eggs, schistosoma hematobium. The 11th one, Paragonimus ringeri, which comes under the lung fluke. So this Paragonimus ringeri is caused from uncooked crabs, those who are eating uncooked crabs. So you, in the feces and sputum analysis, will get, will see the eggs. So the disease called as paragnomiasis. Also, those who are drinking water from pond will get fasciolasis. So there will be an allergy, there will be a bicastic pain. So the feces examination reveal oval shaped yellow eggs with an operculum on one of the poles. Don't forget the 12th one, fasciolasis, drinking water from pond, allergy, epigastric pain, feces examination reveal oval shaped yellow eggs with an operculum on one of the poles. So this wall helminth diseases, which are repeatedly asking in a Croke 1 examination, I am sure that from this 12 definitely you will get one or two questions, because this 12 are repeatedly asking in the 15 years of a Croke 1 examination. So don't fear, if you get helminth, I am sure that you will answer. So thanks for watching. We'll continue to some other topics in some other videos. Thank you.